Hi guys, very welcome to Mentour and yet another video podcast. As always, I hope you're doing absolutely fantastic. Today on the podcast, guys, we're going to be talking about circular runways. Is the end of the era of the straight runway here? Is it likely that we are going to be taking off and landing on circular runways going forward? Stay tuned. Right guys, so circular runway, what is it? Well, you might have seen some YouTube videos about this already, and I've been getting a lot of questions about this, so I thought I was going to give you my view on this subject once and for all. So the idea behind the circular runway was made by a Dutch researcher called Henk Hesselink, and he came up with the idea after having watched a lot of YouTube videos about scary crosswind takeoffs and landings. And he thought maybe there is a better way of constructing runways. Maybe there's a way of constructing them so that crosswind is not really a big issue. And also maybe it can improve the environmental impacts that airports have on their surrounding area, including noise footprint. And what he came up with was basically a circular runway called an infinite runway that is ideally around build in a circle with about a diameter of 3 kilometers and slightly bank sides. Okay, and the idea then is that the airports are supposed to be able to come in and take off and land with a point that always has optimum headwind. All right, it also basically, because it is round, it has the equivalent runway length of about 3 normal runways, so it would facilitate air traffic control to be able to take off multiple aircraft from the same circular runway and also land them on the same circular runway. Okay, so that's the idea behind the circular runway, and it would solve a lot of problems, like for example congested airspaces where people or aircraft would be able to fly in from many different directions. Right, that's the idea. Now I have to stress at this point that this idea is a concept. All right, it is not an idea for how to actually construct an airport. At this point, it's more of a bunch of ideas of how to improve things. So when you hear about circular runways, it is not like Mr. Hesselink is saying that this is how you should be building a runway right now. There are loads and loads of problems, and I'm going to take a few of those problems that I can see as an operational pilot right now. The first one would be the way that an airport is constructed. Now, you need to understand a little bit about the surrounding area of an airport and the reason why an airport is straight in the first place. Okay, there are a couple of reasons. First, in the landing and takeoff direction of a runway, you have an obstacle clearance area. Basically, there's an area where there cannot be any obstacles protruding into that area. Picture kind of like a corridor going in towards an airport and going out from an airport where there cannot be any obstacles because of safety of the arriving and departing aircraft. Now, if you have a circular runway and you're supposed to be able to utilize the whole circle for takeoffs and landings, it means that that obstacle clearance area has to be the same 360 degrees around that airport. So what that means in practical terms is that you're going to need to find an extremely flat area with no buildings, no cities, no mountains or anything around that would infringe on those on the obstacle clearance, basically. If not, then you're going to have different approach minimas and different performance calculations for each degree of those 360 degrees. So that would be one of, the way I see it, one of the major problems of actually constructing the circular runway. Okay, that's one. Second thing is the actual problems of handling. All right, so when we calculate our takeoff performance using a dual engine aircraft, we have to calculate on the risk of an engine failing at any given point. Now, when an engine fails on a dual engine aircraft, it means that you'll get what's called asymmetrical thrust. So the live engine will still be pushing while the dead engine won't, which means that the aircraft will automatically turn towards the dead engine. If you're taking off on a runway that is circular, you have something called centrifugal force that will force the aircraft out towards the edge of the runway as the speed increases. Now, this means that if this would happen at high speed, while you're being pushed up towards the edge of the runway, and then suddenly the outboard engine would fail, well, then you would have an extreme problem with handling. Okay, and this is not something that I've seen them having talked about so far in this concept. So single engine handling during takeoff, I would say, is also a major problem. Then on top of that, you have things like, for example, wind drops. If you start to have slippery runways and you're accelerating up to the equivalent around 250 to 300 kilometers an hour with a 65 ton jet, and the runway is turning and it's slippery, well, you can see yourself why that might be a problem of actually just maintaining the runway, maintaining the aircraft on the runway. Then you have the issue of wingtip clearance. On a banked runway, you will have decreased wingtip clearance on both the inboard and the outboard wing. Okay, there's no way around that, really. The only way to solve that is to construct the aircraft differently. So have, for example, high-mounted wings and engines mounted there, or in the back of the aircraft, like on the MD-11, sorry, on the MD-80, for example. It's unlikely that the aircraft manufacturers is going to be willing to reconstruct existing aircraft fleets in order to accommodate the circular runway. So that is something that I just don't really see happening, and I don't really see any way of getting around it either. Another thing that is going to make the concept of a circular runway even more complicated is the fact that in most major cities today, all of the airport structures are kind of co-located together. So if you take the example of London, for example, you have several big airports working in the same area. And when each of them changes the runway, the other one are affected as well. So they're using the same holding patterns, they're using similar approach aids in order to get in towards the runways. And if London Heathrow, for example, chooses to change the runway, that is going to force, for example, London Luton and Stansted in most cases to change their runways as well. So if you have circular runways in an area like that, and you're constantly changing the way that the aircraft is coming in towards the runway, effectively, that is going to have an effect on every single one of those airports once again. So the whole idea of being fluent and having and being able to change the approach direction on a very short notice is just not really practically doable, at least not with the way that the airports are designed today. But I also want to take this opportunity to say that as a concept, the concept of a circular runway is good, and I like the fact that people are thinking outside of the box. And in 2050, who knows what kind of technology we have around. But seen from the way that I see today, and the fact that I've been in the industry for close to 16 years now, during those 16 years, the only thing that has really changed is the arrival of RNAV approaches. The way that the airports are designed and the way that the obstacle clearance is calculated, our takeoff performance is calculated, has not changed in probably 50 to 60 years. So to think that that will change completely within the next 30 years or so is highly unlikely. Okay, so the answer to the question that you guys have been posing, will we see circular runways? If it's up to me to guess, I would say that we probably won't see any circular runways. Maybe as a concept runway somewhere, but not as a solution to the current problems that the aviation world faces when it comes to capacity. Guys, I hope you like this video. As always, make sure that you subscribe to my YouTube channel. Make sure that you press the notification bell as well, otherwise you won't get any notifications when I post new videos, and send in your questions. I love to get questions from you guys. I hope that you like my live streams that I'm doing every week as well. Make sure you sign up to them and ask your questions there. Have a fantastic day wherever you are, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.